Google Anthos may not be a familiar name to everyone, but it would be hard to consider it a newcomer. Welcome to the Google Anthos video series sponsored by Worldwide Technology. My name is Rob Boyd. Cloud computing is no longer considered somewhere on the hype cycle. There are many benefits that come with an assortment of caveats unique to each situation. It really just depends on how you choose to define it for your own organization. Because every enterprise is on some part of a cloud journey, from the unintentional, gee, I didn't realize that was a cloud, all the way to those fully optimized mobile workloads. Well, the Google Cloud Platform, or GCP, is a suite of cloud computing services running on the same infrastructure that Google itself has been using for the past 12 years. And now there are over 90 products listed under that Google Cloud brand. Well, first introduced in 2019, Google Anthos is an open platform allowing you to run applications anywhere. Anywhere means on-prem or in the cloud. You can even manage workloads running on third-party competitive clouds like Amazon Web Services or Azure. This is one platform made up of multiple technologies. Many are well-developed and understood, and others were introduced more recently, but appear to be well-positioned, carving their own niche. The point is, there's a lot to take in here. There is a lot of value to Google's particular hybrid approach. Worldwide Technology, or WWT as I'll refer to it now, has the expertise, the people, certified by Google to break this down and help us understand these opportunities. So we start this series with this introductory episode by covering the fundamental concepts, the components, and benefits that you can get with Google Anthos. Well, today's featured expert is Spencer Cuff, a cloud architect for WWT. He, like many of us, has been working from home. Unlike my home, however, his is in Denver, Colorado, whereas I'm in Dallas, Texas. Well, no jealousy on my part whatsoever, Spencer. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having me on the show, Rob.
I've been learning a lot from you and the rest of your team, and I'm excited to kick off this series with this introduction, which I think makes sense probably to start with something very basic, which is to say, what is Anthos in your words? How do you describe it?
So Anthos is an application modernization platform. It's going to allow us to take our old on-prem legacy apps and give them that first shove towards becoming more of a cloud native thing.
Gotcha. That first shove. I like that. Okay. Well, so I'm sure we'll come back to back this up, if you will, and show exactly what's meant by all these things. But you went to the trouble of breaking down this introductory part of the series in terms of three categories, three concepts, which are made up of three concepts, six components, and four benefits. In fact, I should probably bring this up on the screen now to show us all what it looks like here. Okay, so of these things, I wonder if you could start breaking down the concepts and say, explain what you mean by what are the most important concepts and how are they going to help us?
So our three core concepts for Anthos are going to be our compute layer, our networking layer, and then our container orchestration or automation layer.
Okay.
So for our compute layer, we're going to have just what everything's running on. So this is going to be your servers running on-prem in your data centers. From our networking perspective, we're going to have more of our service mesh and more of our Kubernetes networking constructs. Mm-hmm. And then from our container orchestration layer, we're going to have all of the things that make it feel more cloud native.
Okay, because conceptually, since we're speaking of concepts, what you're really talking about is some basics that we all understand around the fact that a compute has to occur, that the networking has to occur so that the computes can all speak to each other. But then the things really begin to get different when we talk about container networking and how that pertains to microservices and the communication amongst microservices and doing that in a sustainable and ongoing way. But let's go in, because I want to go into your, because this is where we start to get deep, and this is the part I'm really looking forward to, is going back to your slides here. Let's get into these five components. You've got everything from GKE all the way through to Google Marketplace. But let's start, of course, with GKE, Google Kubernetes Engine. But there's a couple of flavors of that. What is important to understand here?
So the GKE engine is Google's certified version of Kubernetes. This is the same bits that you push out into Google Cloud if you're running Kubernetes in the cloud, but now they've made it portable so that you can run it on-prem in your data center.
Okay, and that's probably a big difference in terms of what Google brings here is obviously there's a huge connection historically with GKE and what Google has done and a lot of what they're doing with Anthos, and it's not to diminish what's been accomplished here, but it's bringing in some mature services and capabilities that have been there, which actually bodes well for anybody that's already a fan of Kubernetes or has worked with some of the extensions or open source projects. So let's get into some of those actually. So switching back over to your slides here, let's talk about the ASM or the Anthos Service Mesh. And I think you have some detail to show here as well in this explanation, because this gets a little bit deeper. In fact, we're going to do additional part of the series here. But what's important about Service Mesh?
So our Anthos Service Mesh is based on the Istio Service Mesh project. This is an advanced container networking infrastructure that allows us to get everything connected, get everything secured, and then apply policy control and auditing across the entire environment. It's going to allow us to enforce things such as mutual TLS to secure communication between our services at the container layer, allow us to control ingress and egress, allow us to control all the authentication and authorization policies our containers are going to be utilizing, and overall just in a more rapid fashion allow us to secure our network and get things up and running.
There's a lot of complexity that goes on within the service mesh, right? And you mentioned Istio and the fact that that is also a name that's going to be recognized for a majority of people that have worked in the Kubernetes environment and using Istio for the service mesh. So again, this is combining a lot of familiar things into a more easy to ingest service, as I'm beginning to understand it. Does that sound about right?
Yep. It's just allowing us to take all these components that traditionally require a lot of management overhead and are more complex to get up and running and configured, and automating them and simplifying the whole process.
Okay. Yep. Okay. I like that. So as we go a little bit further, let's go into the next one on your list. You've got configuration management with ACM. Can you walk us through some detail on that one?
Yeah. So the Anthos configuration management is a combination of a Kubernetes operator running on your cluster and then a declarative configuration file that you host somewhere up on a Git repository. What this allows us to do is take the configuration of our cluster, define it in code in a very declarative fashion, and then have an operator go check state against that file and make sure that our cluster lines up with what it sees. So traditionally with Kubernetes environments, once you start getting a lot of clusters up and running, you're going to start seeing drift in the configuration of the cluster itself. This is just how things happen because a lot of configuration happens at the command line or through some sort of pipeline, and there's no real checks and balances in place for it. So Anthos Config Management allows us to define that and keep it locked into place.
Okay. So obviously an extremely important component. This is the second, along with Service Mesh, where we're going to do a deeper dive with some of your other engineers on the team. And so I know that anybody that's watching this that is already familiar with some of these things probably think, wow, you guys are just skating across the top. And correct, this is an introductory video. It's the beginning part of the series, if you will. Okay, let's go back to your slides here as we continue to check off the list. You've got logging and monitoring. What's important here?
So the logging and monitoring portion of Anthos is going to be Google Stackdriver. They've extended its capabilities now to stretch on-prem so that we can get the data out of our Kubernetes clusters that we're familiar with running and getting in the cloud. So it's going to allow us to take our core logging data, our auditing data, and trace data out of Istio, ship it up into Stackdriver, and do all of the normal analysis on it that we're used to.
Okay. So obviously another important component. The final one that you had here was Google Marketplace, and I'm really curious where this one comes in because this is not something completely new, but I know that there's a lot being planned for it as well as it continues to expand. But Google Marketplace.
So the Marketplace is our traditional Google Marketplace. It's going to allow us to deploy both commercial and open source apps into our environments. Google's wrapped a lot of one-click deployments, so complex deployments that used to take a long period of time can be done in a much more rapid fashion now. And it also gives us the advantage of any commercial apps that have licensing attached to it can now have billing wrapped up into your monthly Google spend.
Okay. Excellent. So that's your five. I'm going to bring up my cheat sheet one more time. So those five components built upon those three concepts. And then finally, which seems funny to put this at the end, but I think some of what you've been covering here makes the most sense at the end, which is to kind of go through these benefits. You've got development, migration, operations, and security. Let's start with development. That feels like the most obvious benefit we would expect out of something like this.
So the development benefit for Anthos is going to be getting your developers more productive and functioning in a more agile way. It's letting us take all of these cloud methodologies that we're used to deploying with and use them on-prem. So the same pipelines, processes, and policies that everything that your developers use now in the cloud can now be applied on-prem.
Okay, that makes complete sense. Okay, well, migration then. This is also kind of a big play for Google in terms of what they're offering uniquely here, yes?
Yeah, so the Migrate for Anthos is a component that's going to let us take a traditional or a virtual machine based server and wrap it into a container. This is the first baby step along the way of modernizing the app and pushing it more into that cloud native space. So your traditional apps are now going to be able to be wrapped with Kubernetes controls, Istio policies, and give you more of that cloud feel to get closer to the next step.
Okay. All right. Well, then operations and security. Operations, it feels like we've kind of covered that in a bunch of different ways, but I guess operations is also about how we interact or set up our developers, how we continue to move the organization forward. Are there other important things to call out there in terms of operations benefits?
Yeah, the operations security pieces kind of go hand in hand. A lot of that is going to come into play with our service mesh and our configuration management. It's going to allow us to, in an automated and orchestration fashion, apply policy, control traffic, and do all the configuration deployment for our clusters in a seamless, unified way.
Gotcha. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense because I know, you know, we split these things down as part of this into their component parts, and anybody that has attempted to do this on their own, and there, of course, are a ton of smart people that are doing those very things, you immediately run into stuff like you're mentioning with the service mesh and this and the authentication between services that are those things allowed to happen? What's your visibility into those services communicating with each other? How are you controlling their use of the processors and so on and so forth? And you know, and how do they know when things move? How do they know that something's on-prem versus in the cloud and which cloud is it in? Anyway, this stuff rapidly brings a lot of stuff together, but it also highlights for me the fact that you know, everyone is on a different place, I feel like, in terms of their cloud journey. You know, every enterprise that I've ever worked with, some are extremely mature, some are somewhat in the realm of not sure that they were even doing cloud or what exactly that defined, you know, because we've got some loosey definitions on that type of stuff. But obviously, this is where things are moving. It's not anything that is considered out there that someone's still thinking about. Everybody is somewhere there. But I want to just wrap up in terms of understanding worldwide technology. You guys are very well versed. You've got multiple experts across multiple types of clouds because each of you get your certifications. You work with customers in specific areas, but you also work together to help people answer these kind of questions. Can you talk a little bit about what makes WWT different?
Sure. We have an entire multi-cloud practice that's dedicated to all the flavors of the cloud out there. Kubernetes is stretching across all of them now. And Google is working with all of the clouds to get Anthos and Google Kubernetes Engine running everywhere. So a lot of this you can see in our digital platform, which is a portal which contains all our blogs, white papers, video series that just lets you get immersed into the cloud experience.
Yeah, one thing I love is you guys have obviously invested heavily in the Advanced Technology Center, and that's been built out. I last was there, it was in 2016, and haven't been there since, but from everything that's been described to me, it's grown exponentially since then. And as much as I've always encouraged everybody to physically stop by your facilities in St. Louis, you don't have to be there. You guys have continued to invest in your digital platform, same place we're hosting these videos, and so you can go back and get the entire series because there's a whole lot more information there. And so I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, customers and or just someone that's interested in learning more about you guys and or about services and opportunities for learning and getting smarter about everything, they can create a My WWT account, I believe, on your site. Begin to interact and just get engaged to whatever level of depth that they think is appropriate, correct?
Correct, yeah. This is a great way to get engaged with us, get that first step so that you can try to start figuring this out and plan your journey to get to the cloud.
Excellent, excellent. Well, I know you're in Denver, so you can't meet anybody in St. Louis, but I appreciate your time. Is there anything else that you want to cover before we wrap things up here?
The rest of the series is going to be coming, so definitely watch for that. And yeah. Thank you for doing the series with us, Rob.
Absolutely. I like the fact that you promoted the series. That's awesome. All right. Well, guys, well, thank you to Worldwide Technology for sponsoring this educational series. All of this content is available at their website, specifically the ATC Innovation Ecosystem, ATC being short for Advanced Technology Center, that physical multi-vendor paradise. It's also worth touring if you're in the St. Louis area, but certainly should be checking that out. So you don't have to travel out there to interact. You can go online. Cloud, networking, security, and of course, today's topics all around Anthos. Work with those experts. Learn how you can make all of this smoother. Remember to drop me any questions you may have. I'm Rob at explainnerds.net or hit me up on Twitter. I'll put all that information there in the graphics below the screen. Thank you so much.